Whether you're a business owner making your own videos or simply creating video content on behalf of a business, you'll most likely encounter the issue of maintaining a consistent visual identity for the brand. For each moment that you need to add a logo or use an exact shade of a color, you pause your workflow to find a file or reference a style guide PDF. To remedy this, we've introduced brand kits into PowerDirector. But what are brand kits? A brand kit refers to a collection of guidelines and assets that define the visual identity of a brand. Typically, it'll include elements like your logo, typography, color palette, and other visual elements. It's what makes your brand recognizable for consumers across all sorts of platforms and materials. Brand kits can be found upon opening up PowerDirector and scrolling down on the Media tab. To start setting up your brand kit, click on the pencil icon at the top of the menu window. It'll prompt you to enter a name for your brand kit. If you have multiple businesses to create for, this is an easy way to organize the different assets. Now you can upload your logos, brand-approved colors, photos, background images, music, intro and outro videos, and fonts. A cool thing to note here is that once you've added your logo, the program will automatically add the colors in your logo to the brand kit. If you want to delete the suggestions, just right-click and press delete. You can add colors by simply clicking on the big plus icon. You can find your brand color by either typing in the hex code or using the color picker on the side. Click OK to add. For background images, you can either import a file from your computer or select a color board. For fonts, you can either type in the name of the font you're looking for or scroll through and find it in the list. You can add multiple fonts here as well. Click on the trash can icon if you want to delete a chosen font. Once you're satisfied with the sections you've filled in, click on the OK button at the bottom. Now, when you're editing a video, you'll be able to quickly access all of these assets. Most of these assets will be in the Media tab, with the exception of fonts, which will be at the top of the list of fonts when you edit any text in your videos. Lastly, when switching between brand projects, toggle between brand kits by using the drop-down menu at the top of the window. In your projects, you'll be able to utilize your brand kit to add and resize logos, change the backgrounds, edit in music, all while maintaining your brand's visual identity. With brand kits, you've got consistent on-brand designs for all of your video projects. If you're looking for more tutorials on video marketing, stay tuned. There is more to come in the near future. Just remember to subscribe so you're not missing out. We'll see you in the next one.